And but for to be more confident, if you want to be more confident about your add method, you should write a bit more assertions. You can or so you can add more assertions, like you can try sending negative numbers, you can try sending number numbers with decimal points, and write different assertions. And if you run the PHPUnit again, then it will show you that you ran two tests, but much more assertions. Like it will show the number of assertions, and it should, all of them should pass if the add method works correctly. So I will show you a unit test for the subtract method. But if you go to the GitHub repo of this example code, you will see the unit test for the subtract method. I would like to talk a little bit about integration testing, because if you ever wrote a WordPress plugin, you probably thinking that, hey, it's up with the, I don't write only the simple calculator classes. Usually your WordPress plugins add metadata to costs, change some options inside the options table, use some other classes. So in that case, if you want to test integration with WordPress, it's very similar to unit tests. So unit tests are isolated to your code. It doesn't run anything else than other your code. But for if your code is being integrated with some others, if it's being integrated with other classes, with WordPress, then you write very similar code for testing, but those tests are called integration tests. Let's say this code. Let's say we add one more class called PostUpdater, and it has a constructor, and this constructor expects the calculator instance, that's the instance of the class we just created, and it has an update method. Update method receives a post ID and two numbers, and those two numbers, it will add those two numbers using the calculator's add method. So we're passing those numbers as an argument, you see. And it adds this value as a metadata to that post ID as unit tested plugin demo metadata key. With that key, it adds this to the post method. So how you test this update method? As I mentioned, very similar. So I'm creating another test file, test-post-updater.php. In this class, I have this it updates the post meta method. Notice that it's not starting with test. So I can start the name with test prefix. But for integration tests, it's better to give a very descriptive expected functionality. It's like a matter of choice. You can decide. You can name them with test prefix. You can also use this test dot block. So anyway, we have a test. It creates the instance of post updated class, but if you remember, it's expecting an instance of calculator. So we're creating a new calculator and passing it to PostUpdater's constructor. Now, look at this code. This factory post create. This is one of the benefits of using this WP unit test case. And WP unit test case provides you with these factories. So you can easily create on the fly, generate new post, and use it inside your test. Once your test passes, it destroys. Once your test suite runs, the WordPress test suite automatically destroys everything that is created inside the test database. So it will not be permanent. So it creates a new post and returns its Now you have a post ID. Now you can run that post updater's update method, send that post ID, and send some numbers to it. So it's, we expect that this code will add these two numbers and update the post meter, right? It's adding to the post meter. So we can assert it. We can write an assertion to it. And here, I'm reading the post meter now. I'm not checking the result of the function. It's not returning anything. I'm checking what it did, if it did the job I expected it to do. So I'm reading the post meter using the post ID and the method key, and then I'm asserting that it's equal to 5. So it, now here I'm reading it from the database. So the value is being read from the database. So if you're a test, write to a file, open a database connection, do something over the network, run some API calls, then those tests are most likely integration tests. So that's what integration tests do. So testing or writing tests can be a bit hard to get started, but it's like physical exercise. So it's hard to get started, you need to motivate yourself. First, it may seem pointless why you need to do this, but in the long term, you will see the benefit. You will see the benefit as soon as you do very, like, a little bit significant change in your code, a little bit significant refactoring in your code, and you will see the benefit. You will see how it will be easy to refactor your code, change the example function names, class names, move them over to other folders, and etc. So you will immediately see that. So I'll give you some links to learn more about this. So you can I'll tweet a link to this presentation after this talk. So you can go to the links to these links to learn more about this stuff. So you can go to the sample code I used for this presentation. I even integrated that code with Travis CI, so you can see how these tests are being automatically ran in the continuous integration environment, because it's being executed. As soon as I push some change, Travis CI launches these unit tests using different versions of WordPress, different versions of PHP, and shows me the result. So there is a link on the README file too. You can go and see the result of those tests and see how it's being used. Of course, go to code pages of well-known WordPress plugins like JPEG, Yoast, or M for WP, others that you know. we do code reviews. So you should make it practice. You should start the practice of doing code reviews. So probably everyone now uses Git. And if you use GitHub or GitLab, it allows you to create pull requests or merge requests to your code. So it's if you are not familiar with it, it's just the developer creates a branch from the main branch. Does everything what he wants, but he cannot merge the master branch. He cannot merge the release branch. He doesn't. We disable access to the main branch, but they can create a pull request or merge request. The merge request is just asking information from the senior developer or other team members to see this code, what he changes, and merge it, put the merge button, so it automatically merge to the main branch.
So you
before clicking that merge button,
yeah,
I manually review it, and if there are issues, I can comment right away there, ask them to change it, and send it back. So code reviews.
So you just have it as an internal policy that no one can merge unless there's a unit test.
Yes. Another thing you could do is creating automated coverages. It's a bit hard to do with WordPress plugins, but still you can do it. So coverage reports shows how many percent of your code is being covered by tests. It shows how much of your code was executed when you ran the unit test. So you can automate that and see that number too. It is all supposed to be covered with tests or
yes. It seems like the tests are only as good as the assertions that you come up with. Do you have how do you come up with assertions? I mean, the calculator one was a little bit simplified, but is there some way you come up with those assertions?
So you just identify what you were expecting.
Okay.
So you just identify what you were expecting, then you choose the assertion. For example, if you are expecting that you will get the array as a return value, you get an array, then you assert that the return value is array. If you are expecting that the array contains 5 items, then you run count function and assert that the result is equal to 5. And if you're expecting that one of the items will be, let's say, number 1, then you can assert that this array contains number 1. So you should just identify the expectation and you can choose the assertion.
Just to add to that, as a policy, we'll go through negative testing, special characters testing, null values, undefined values. So we use a hybrid of test-driven development, come up with all that first, and then go ahead and build our test case based off of that.
I hope I understood that correctly. So you test on your local machine before you push to, let's say, to GitHub. Yes. Yesterday we heard a speech where you push to GitHub and then all the test starts running. What's your opinion on that?
Yes, you should run on your local first, but you have to run it on servers too, because if you have more than one member of the team. So everyone pushes the code and the CI server runs the automatically. And also when you run the code locally, when you run your test locally on your machine, you may choose to run it using only one version of WordPress. But the CI tools, you can configure it to run the test with different versions of PHP, with different versions of WordPress. And if you go to the GitHub repo, you will see it. It's already configured to run with multiple versions of PHP and WordPress. So you should do it if you have a team.
When you ran that WP scaffold command, WP-CLI command, was that a scaffold for an entire plugin or just for the unit testing for the plugin?
Yeah, good question. I forgot to mention that. It creates a new plugin. What the command I mentioned creates a new plugin. But one